I mean, to me, I see people like Bill O'Reilly on television, right? And I see how much they control the media. Like, there's this girl on Bill O'Reilly the other night from an organization saying the world can't wait. And this girl was spot on. Everything she was saying was the truth. And all Bill O'Reilly could do was call her a lunatic. He couldn't challenge the facts. They just call people names. They can't, and until we just find that, look, this world, we're heading into a world of danger, possible nuclear wars, you know, because the banking industry is trying to take over the world. 9/11 is the beginning of the war on terror. That war on terror is leading us into Iraq, which is the next lie. So you had the lie of 9/11, how that happened. No, nobody knows how Building 7 came down. Okay, we know 9/11 was a fraud. The American people don't know it, but more and more of them are believing it. Okay, so that was the first lie. Besides the inception, I'm not going back to the inception of the Federal Reserve, that original lie. But 9/11 was the first lie in this present state we're in. 9/11 is the kickoff of the war against the American people and the people of the world. 9/11 was a phony. It's a fraud. It didn't happen the way they told us it happened. Now, because of 9/11, we then had the authority to go into Afghanistan and Iraq. Iraq didn't have weapons of mass destruction, okay? So that was the next lie. Now they're talking about going into Iran. Now, how would you feel if you were Iran and you had this big, powerful country, America, go into your next-door neighbor, take over their oil fields, right? Wouldn't you be worried about what they were going to do to you? Of course you're going to be worried. But the people of America don't think about it from Iran's point of view. They think about it from our point of view. So now we're going to send more troops into Iraq and keep building up because they want Iraq and the Middle East to become part of the New World Order. And Iraq was using, Saddam wanted to start using euros instead of dollars, right?
He was messing up their
whole consumption. Iran wants to start using euros instead of dollars.
They are, they have.
Okay? So I'm saying what they're trying to do is preserve their power. And one lie leads to the next lie, leads to the next lie. And until you get to the root cause of 9/11, which is supposedly the war on terror, we'll never solve our problems here. Should we send more troops into Iraq? Should we not send more troops into Iraq? Well, the truth is, the fact is, that it all goes back to this war on terror. Where did 9/11 come from? That's the root cause of everything. And until we have a full investigation, find out why Building 7 fell down, why they shipped all the steel out of America so quickly, you know, from the buildings, why all the things that don't make any sense about 9/11, until we find out why it really happened, you know, we'll never understand why there's a war on terror. And we'll never be able to prove that the war on terror is a phony. You know, Nick and I discussed many things. One of the things we discussed, what he brought up in conversation, was reducing world population and felt that there were too many people in the world. In a way, I agree, there are too many people in the world, but I don't think I have the authority to say who's going to die and who's not going to die, you know. But they felt that they wanted to reduce world population, and he felt that it should be reduced by half. He even mentioned to me once they were having a real problem trying to solve the Israel-Palestinian problem. And he talked to me once about they were playing with the idea of bringing Israel to Arizona, you know, and taking all the people from Israel and giving everybody $1 million and setting up Israel in the state of Arizona.
Unbelievable.
Just to end that problem, because that's a problem that they're not in charge of, in a sense. They're not controlling that problem. They're very arrogant. They can do whatever they want to do. We've given these people the authority to create money out of thin air. And through that device, they control everything. And if you want to win the battle to stop that, you have to deny them the ability to create money. It's only because they can make money that they have all this power.
They literally have the money machines.
They have the money machines. They can print it. They can do whatever they want to do. They own everything.
Aaron, we take over pretty quick. If we were the guys that issued the money, everybody had to come give us real assets for the use of this money we just printed up.
You know, I tell people, you know, why in the world does the American government borrow money from the banks when they have the ability to create it themselves without borrowing it and paying interest on it? Why? And nobody can answer that question. Not one politician ever raises that. Why does the American government borrow money when they can create it without paying interest?
Well, we did create it up until 1913.
And so people say, well, because if the American government does it, it'll create inflation. That's the answer. I say, well, let's look at it. The American government has the Federal Reserve do it, which creates the same inflation as if they did it. But also with the inflation, now you're getting massive debt. So with the Federal Reserve, you have inflation and debt. Now, if the American government made the money, backed by gold, which limited the amount they could make, you wouldn't have debt and you wouldn't have inflation.
But inflation was only about 50% from the 1780s, I've looked it up, until the late 1800s. And then we have the central banks already trying to cause some panics, which they then used to push the Federal Reserve. And if we look at inflation since 1913 into 2007, it's exponential. In fact, a dollar is worth about 2 pennies what it was worth in 1913. Former Federal Reserve Chairman Alan Greenspan doubled the money supply from 2000 to 2006. And then Edward Bernanke, the new Fed chief, came in and said he's going to double it again in the next 2 years. And then he said, now I'm going to make the money supply numbers secret. And so now we don't even know.
Right.
But the evidence is they are just, I mean, in the curve of inflation, it gradually grows. And then suddenly at a point, it goes straight up. And it seems
It's parabolic, yeah.
Yeah, parabolic.
But the thing is that the only thing I disagree with you on from early 1800 to 1913, there was no inflation other than during the Civil War. You know, when Lincoln was
printing. Well, I'm talking about how much a dollar was worth. And I know
Never changed. There was no inflation. In that whole 100 years, there was no inflation. People knew what the money was worth. They could retire. They knew what it would cost them to live their lives out. There was no problem. It was only since 1913 when the Fed came in that we created massive inflation and massive debt.
So then what you said earlier, then there really wasn't inflation.
There was no inflation.
So you don't get inflation when the government issues the money, at least in the U.S. history.
Well, not if it's backed by gold.
Well, exactly. But I'm talking about, and I did look this up, and I believe that if you look after the country was set up and some of the things happened with Andrew Jackson and the rest of it, there were points where it spiked and there were manipulations.
There were points, mostly during the Civil War.
Yeah. And that's because Lincoln printed so much money.
Exactly. That's right. But once that ended, but basically there was no inflation other than that during that short period of time. I mean, a loaf of bread was a loaf. Of course, the same thing. People could plan their lives. Today, they planned inflation. Now you have two parents working. They can't afford to pay for their family anymore. The kids are going to state-run schools now. The kids are being indoctrinated how to think. They're being given Ritalin. They're being given all these drugs. The whole country's being dumbed down. It's all because of the Federal Reserve System. And the Federal Reserve System and these bankers are responsible for the demise of America. And if we ever want to win this battle, you must shut down the Federal Reserve System. And we must shut down these bankers and restore sound money to this country.